For this tutorial, I'm going to show how to build a search. So, students, I'm going to do the asterisk, which is a wildcard search. So everything after students would show up, versus if I just search student, it might not search for students. I do want to search all record types, but you can limit to collections or digital materials. So keyword is the default, but you can pick title, creator, subject, notes, or identifier, which is the collection number. I'm going to keep that as a keyword. I'm not going to do year. Then if you hit the plus sign, you get another search field. Let's do scrapbooks again. I'm just going to do that. This time, though, I want scrapbook in the title. But not, let's say, 4-H. Okay. Okay, so that's 72. 72 results isn't bad at all. If you don't want to scroll through three pages, you can again filter the results. You can search within the results or narrow it down by year. Ephemera. Okay. So, again, here's collection information, additional description, has the abstract, subjects, what collecting areas this falls under, the university archives, other administrative information, and details on our repository, which is our department. Organized, physical storage information, so it is really just one box. To go back, so this is the folder level. If you want to go back up to the main finding aid, you can go up here where it says scrapbook. So to the top here, and you can hit back button also, but there are some breadcrumbs. So here at the top, you can go here, and I don't believe there's a way to get back to the results, the 72 results, besides the back button, but if you wanted to do a fresh search or to go to our home page, I think we'd go to home.